I'm Lara Idiarte, CMT, and I'm here to help you elevate your investing strategy with Elliott Wave. My course covers everything from identifying and labelling Elliott Waves to understanding Fibonacci ratios and predicting market movements. This is your opportunity to gain a powerful toolset for making smarter investment decisions. Our student Laurie says, "This course transformed my understanding of Elliott Wave theory." Hirofumi says, "My investment returns have soared since taking this course. Lara's insights are invaluable." Right now, you can still get $100 off the Learn Pure Elliott Wave course. And don't forget, you can also grab my Pure Technical Analysis and Buy Low Sell High courses at massive discounts during checkout. This combination is designed to supercharge your investing strategy. Click on the link below now to secure your discount and transform your investing approach before it's too late. Hello everybody, this is Lara from Pure Elliott Wave with your Monday to Friday update for Bitcoin, Ethereum, XRP and Solana. As of next week, I'll be doing Bitcoin and XRP and Jack Frost will come in and do Ethereum and Solana. But for this week, I think it looks like I'm doing all of them. He might be back tomorrow for a video for you. So you're going to get both of us working for you now. Bitcoin is still consolidating and it looks like it's going to head on lower within this rectangle. Price has been within it since 28th of February, so nearly 4 months now of all of this sideways movement. I did have a look at the big picture. A couple of videos ago, Bitcoin's big picture, I think the thumbnail is Bitcoin in a bear market. I had a look at the monthly time frame and I had a look at how much mucking around it did previously when it reached prior all-time highs before it shot up away. And we've seen this kind of behavior before. Not quite as long lasting, but we have seen mucking around lasting a couple of months. It's same, different. And this is entirely possible that it's still in a bull market. What's most likely is it's not in a bear market. We're seeing sideways movement. We're not seeing real strength and downward movement. And we're not seeing increasing volume and increasing range as price moves lower. The last test of resistance, 71,500, price has moved successfully away from that, so expect overall downward movement to continue to 60,700. And when price gets about there, if stochastics is properly oversold, that may be where and when the downward swing ends. When rectangles occur in the context of an upward trend or following upward movement, two-thirds of the time they'll break out up, one-third of the time they'll break out down, so balance of probability still expects an upward breakout. For the very short term, volume is now strongest on downward sessions, so there's a little bit of push from volume. Expect price to continue lower. On balance, volume, however, is giving quite strong bearish signals. This may suggest we could see a downward breakout from the rectangle, but the signal happened while price was quite a distance from support, so it might also just be expecting price to continue lower to support. We still have to wait and see how price behaves when it gets down to support. Just a warning, on balance volume is suggesting a downward breakout might be more likely. ADX is now indicating there's a downward trend for the short term. It's indicated swings within the rectangle before, downward swing here, upward swing here, upward swing, and now again a downward swing. RSI's got a little way to go before it reaches oversold, so downward movement may very well continue. Money flow also is a distance off oversold. ATR continues to decline as price falls. This is what I mean when I say there isn't strength in downward movement. Volume is not particularly strong. Overall, it's still declining, although for the short term, some push on downward sessions. ATR as a measure of volatility is also declining. If this was a bear market, we would be expecting to see volume increasing as price moves lower, and especially ATR increasing as price moves lower. That's what happens in Bitcoin's bear markets. That's not what is happening now. Ethereum continues sideways this week with resistance at 3680 and support at 3200. Previous, this strong upward movement had a really big increase in range and strong push from volume. This is a hallmark of a bullish move, not a counter trend movement in a bear market. Volume and volatility favor the upside for Ethereum quite strongly. That supports a bullish case for Ethereum for the long term. As price is moving lower, there was some decent push for 17th of June, so we may see a bit more downward movement. The last signal given from on balance volume was a break below support. We broke below support here, tested, broke back above and back below. So I'm going to get rid of that line actually. That's got weak technical significance. On balance volume is above support, no new signal. ADX is declining. There's no clear trend for Ethereum at this time frame. Stochastics reached oversold, almost properly oversold recently. Stochastics is moving higher. Expect overall price might continue higher within its consolidation and may continue up until prices reaches resistance. My Elliott Wave count for XRP remains the same. I expect a second wave correction may be complete down here for minute wave 2. Minute wave 3 within minor wave 1 may be in its early stages with 1, 2, now expecting 3, 4, 3, 4, 5 to complete an impulse most likely for minor wave 1. If minuet 2 continues lower, it may not move beyond the start of 1 below 0.4565. Technicals on the daily for XRP, there was an ascending triangle, a downward breakout. Ascending triangles most commonly break out upward, but they can be continuation or reversal patterns. They can break up or down. Here was the downward breakout on a downward session with push from volume, and now just sideways movement. The target from the triangle was 0.4227. I have said I do think that's probably too low. In order to have any confidence over it, we need to see price close below support at 0.46, a break below support, and then we could see then we could probably use this target. But for now, look for resistance at 54.55 cents, support at 46 cents. Recent strongest session for XRP was on a downward session, so for the short term, the volume profile is bearish. A weak bearish signal from XRP here, a new support line here, no new range, no new signal. ADX is declining, there's no clear trend. Stochastics neared oversold, it's overall moving higher, choppy and overlapping. For now, expect overall price to continue higher to about 55 cents. The Elliott Wave count for Solana is playing out exactly as expected. I'm moving the invalidation point down. It expects a zigzag for primary wave 4 to continue lower, for intermediate C to end at or below the end of A, so to reach 119.38481 or below. The target would see that achieved. The target is the 0.618 Fibonacci ratio of primary 3 at 117.436. Intermediate C must subdivide as a 5-wave motive structure. It looks likely to be an impulse. I have 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. And now we need 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 5. Each of the fourth waves may not move into corresponding first wave price territory. Subminuet 4 has remained just below subminuet wave 1 price territory. There's a little space between them. As soon as subminuet 5 moves beyond the end of 3 at 130.28908, at or below that point, it will avoid a truncation. As soon as that happens, minuet 3 may be complete. A brief sharp bounce from minuet 4 may not move into minuet 1 price territory above 145.89122. Another wave down to end at or below the end of wherever 3 is, and then another little bounce from minute 4 may not move into minute wave 1 price territory. Likewise, minor 4 may not move into minor wave 1 price territory. But once we've had the middle of the third wave, which I think has just passed, we should be expecting to see brief shallow bounces. They could be over even within a session. These fourth waves may be more brief than their counterpart second waves. That's really common for cryptocurrencies. We could see the end of primary wave 4 coming up quite soon, and it could end with a sharp downward spike and a huge bullish wick like we saw back here for 13th of April. Now, I am expecting C to end at or below the end of A to avoid a truncation, because truncations are very rare. Very quickly, technicals for Solana. It is moving lower. Resistance at 157. Look out for how it's going to behave. If it gets down to support at 127, looks like it's going to get there. Volume pushing price lower for the short term. Expect more downward movement is quite likely. The last signal from on-balance volume was bearish. Broke below support. Back test of resistance. Moving down and away. Supports the Elliott Wave count. ADX tells us there's a downward trend. RSI is not oversold, nor is money flow. A little way to go before the trend reaches extreme. This technicals strongly support the Elliott Wave count. That's it for me today with your quick update. I hope you're all having a lovely day.